This is an Israelite Jewels recording.
Chapter 6. This is the story of Nimrod, son of Cush, who was the son of Ham, who was Noah's son, the first man to become mighty on earth after the days of the flood. He became a mighty hunter in opposition to Jehovah. Before the flood, there was water on the surrounding layer of the sky, for on the second day of creation, God made an expansion around the earth, and upon this expansion there was indeed a separation between the waters beneath it, that is, the oceans, and the waters above it, for from ancient times there was a surface of water in the sky, shimmering in the light of the sun, which covered the whole surface of the earth. Because of this there were fruits and seeds in abundance everywhere, for behold, a dew rose from the ground every day, and watered all the plants, and there were no deserts, but all the land was productive. Nevertheless, after the flood occurred, behold, the whole surface of the earth underwent a drastic change, for behold, all the springs of the vast water of depth were broken, and the floodgates of the heavens were opened, and even the lofty hills were covered, all that were under all the heavens. 3. As soon as the waters of the flood descended, behold, God commanded Noah to awaken all the animals one last time, because God had made them sleep according to the time that was necessary to sleep for a long period of time, until he woke them up, for the third and last time, slowly, one at a time, so that from there they would spread to the ends of the earth and spread the seeds they carried within themselves, to germinate the earth again, quadruped animals, and beasts, and reptiles of the earth, and birds of the sky, yea, everyone, no matter the species, from small to great, all the animals that had hitherto been fed on all kinds of seeds and fruit, since God had decreed to the descendants of Noah the command to feed on all that moves on the face of the earth and also for the animals not to die of hunger, since the earth would no longer deliver its fruit in abundance as it happened before the deluge. And so, as before God gave us the vegetables and their seeds, now God was saying that all living things can be food for both men and animals, for there was nothing on the surface of the ground to feed them. And God blessed all living beings, that they might be fruitful, and replenish the earth, every man according to his kind. It was then given that after releasing the beasts, that God commanded Noah to gather and sprinkle on the flat roof of the ark, all the seeds which he had stocked upon the command of God, to be planted again after the flood, and, behold that a wind from the north blew above the ark, and the seeds were scattered about where Noah and his family were, and to the four corners of the earth, and wherever they fell, they quickly germinated and bore fruit according to their kind. Among the sons of Noah were the descendants of Japheth, Tarshish, Kittim, and Dodanim, who began to use the knowledge of Japheth in the building of the ark to build great fishing vessels, and from these came the first inhabitants of the islands that spread themselves over their territories, and though they all spoke the same language, every new place inhabited, developed their own customs of speech, according to their families and according to their nations. Then, after the flood and the destruction of all the ungodly people in the world of mankind, Noah and his descendants were to rebuild the new earth, which would be pure in the sight of God, for all the earth had passed away by a baptism, for the purpose of representing a new creation in the sight of the heavens. It was thus that true worship was restored again by Noah and the other seven survivors of the flood at the beginning of the time they left the ark as a symbol of deliverance for offering sacrifices to Jehovah under Noah's leadership. He built an altar to God and took some of all the pure animals and all the pure flying creatures that were among them, and made burnt offerings on the altar in praise and thanks to God for his act of salvation in regard to the sons of men and all the animals he selected to exist on the inhabited earth. But the adversary of God, Satan the devil, was still lurking in order to distill his spirit in the sons of Noah, as he had in the beginning with the descendants of Adam and Eve. And it came to pass, that Satan found in the young Nimrod, the son of Cush, descending from Ham, the same rebellious disposition that he had found in Cain for his ancestor Noah. After Nimrod heard from his father the account in which his grandfather discovered the nakedness of Noah, and that he became drunk, behold, this caused him repugnance for his grandfather. Satan, therefore, begins to interact in his sentiments, and to develop in Nimrod, for how much he was still a boy, the desire to overlap the blessing of Noah upon his descendant Shem, that it would be through him and his seed that the future descendant would come, through the genealogy of the righteous descendants of Adam, to Abram, whom God later took from among the people of Ur of the Chaldees, to strengthen their covenant with the righteous sons of Adam, to begin with Seth, Enos, Canaan, Mahalalel, Jared, Enoch, Methuselah, Lamech, Noah, Shem, Arphaxad, Salah, Eber, Peleg, Reu, Serug, Nahor, Terah and Abram. Therefore, Nimrod would be outside the presidency of the priesthood, and even of possibility of the promised descendant coming from his seed. It was then that Satan proceeded to stir up the heart of Nimrod for the purpose of becoming a mighty hunter in opposition to Jehovah, which means in the language of the Hebrews, hunter of men, that is, one who hunts men with purpose of enslaving, thus acting in opposition to the precepts of freedom extended to all men created by Jehovah. In this way, Nimrod, backed by Satan, became a warrior and conqueror of people.